You may have heard about this new portable Bluetooth cassette player that's going to be released soon. It's been featured on various websites such as The Verge, TechCrunch, TechSpot, and even New York Post. And they all talk about how it's coinciding with the 40th anniversary of the Sony Walkman, even though this is not a Sony product. And they keep talking about how it's the world's first Bluetooth cassette player, so you can use it with wireless headphones or connect it to a Bluetooth speaker, so you don't have to use an old-fashioned headphone jack anymore, even though it does have one. It's going to cost $75. It'll be available in pink, white, or navy blue, which is vaguely similar to the original color of the Sony Walkman. And it also mentions how it'll come with a blank tape. Now, why would it come with a blank tape if it's supposed to be a cassette player and it's supposed to be reminiscent of the Sony Walkman? Well, it's actually a cassette recorder. I'll show you the official Kickstarter page here. They had a $12,805 goal. So far, they've raised over $59,000. With 710 backers so far. Reappearance of the romance of the 80s portable cassette in more perfection. Unrestricted enjoyment of music. And here they mention, able to record warm messages in personalized format with a cassette tape. And they show all the articles and sites it's been featured on. They keep talking about plug in your headphones, even though it has Bluetooth. Press play, listen to music. And here they talk about recording onto cassette, and here's their official diagram. It has a clear lid. I first thought it didn't even have a lid. It actually has a clear lid. There you can see the buttons. There's the built-in microphone. There's a switch to turn on or off the Bluetooth output, showing the different colors. And here's finally the specifications. It does have auto stop at end of tape, one touch recording, built-in microphone, and you see right here, classic monaural sound. So they keep talking about how, oh, you can listen to music, it's just like your Walkman that you had back in the 80s. Well, I bet your Walkman wasn't mono. All the Walkmans I remember, never used, were all in stereo. This thing is mono. It's not even stereo. That's because here it is on Alibaba. You can buy it directly from China for as little as $7 each if you buy enough of them. I bet if they have enough orders, they can get them for that $7 price each. There you can see the same button layout, same mechanism inside. They just changed the color of the door to clear and tacked on the Bluetooth output. This one actually is a little better. It has a built-in AM/FM radio, which this Kickstarter project does not. So if they swap out the built-in radio for a Bluetooth output, it's probably going to come out to about the same price to get it built. Although another thing it's missing on the Kickstarter version is a built-in speaker. So this one has a built-in speaker and built-in AM/FM radio, or at least FM, while the Kickstarter version does not. See, the button layout is the same. And it says 2014, so this is not a new product in any way, shape, or form. It's been around for quite a while. It's manufactured by Skywind, the same company that makes record player mechanisms for those really cheap suitcase-style record players from brands like Crosley and Victrola. Also on this Alibaba listing for this version, it claims to have a ST, I guess that means stereo phones jack, so even though it's mono, it probably does at least play through both channels of your headphones. It's just not going to be stereo. And the claimed price is $75. Isn't even going to be the final retail price. They're saying it's a 15% off discount for backing the Kickstarter project. So the final retail price, if this is the case, will be around $86 for something that if you buy enough of them, you can get for $7 each from the manufacturer in China. So here's their timeline. Again, they try to tie it to the original Sony Walkman, and they apparently came up with the idea last October and did feasibility studies in December, and supposed to ship in December 2019. The good thing is this is not a scam. It is a real product, and it probably will actually ship on the date they claim it will ship, because it already exists. It's already fully designed. The product is already being manufactured. All they have to do is take out the radio and put in the Bluetooth output module. And as for that Bluetooth output module, that's another off-the-shelf part. And if you buy enough of them, you can get them for $1 each. So the ultimate bill of goods for this $75 Bluetooth cassette recorder is $7 for the cassette recorder itself, $1 for the Bluetooth output module, and they mentioned they're going to throw in a 60-minute blank tape. Well, that's 78 cents each. So that's $8.78 of manufacturing costs for a product that's ultimately going to have a retail price of around $86. So that's a bargain. That's only 1,000% markup. But don't worry, it's okay. Only music can heal you. And if you want to relive your nostalgia of having a Walkman back in the 80s and 90s, of course you could get original Sony Walkman, although the better models in good working condition, or the ones that have been professionally restored, are quite pricey. But the, you know, if you're lucky, you can get one pretty cheaply. They seem to go for around $50, more or less. But you don't have to spend even that much. You can get this brand new for under $20. It's the Jensen SCR68C stereo cassette player with AM/FM radio. And it's basically the same thing as the last generation really cheap Walkmans before they got discontinued. For example, it only has play and fast forward. It does not have rewind. So if you want to rewind a tape, you got to flip it over and fast forward it on the other side. Just like the trick people learned how to do back in the 80s and 90s.
The early versions, anyway, they didn't have rewind.
You know, That's right, you had to put it over yeah, and forward it.
If you wanted to rewind, you'd have to take the tape
and fast forward.
Has a built-in AM/FM radio tuner. Although, disappointingly, the FM is mono. It's not actually stereo on FM. And it has one of those annoying DSP-based tuners that makes it very choppy to tune in a station. Although, surprisingly, the AM has very good reception and surprisingly good sound quality. So at least the AM is pretty decent. It does play in stereo on tape, so it is a true stereo headphone jack. Even comes with cheap little earbuds, although you probably don't want to use these. And it actually doesn't sound that bad when playing tapes. I was actually quite surprised. It's really kind of okay. Not any worse than many of the Walkmans and imitation Walkmans I had back in the 90s when I was a kid. And if you want to slow down your tape to make it sound like vaporwave music, it's very easy with this cassette player. You just remove the four screws from the back cover and it easily pops off. And then right here is your motor speed trimmer. Just use a small flat blade screwdriver, just that trimmer, left or right to adjust the speed, and there you go. They do actually give you a little hole in the case to get to it, but it's too small for the size of the trimmer in here to be any good. So you need to take off the back cover, but it's very easy. Only four screws and it just pops right off. There you can also see your main drive belt. Plastic flywheel, but what do you expect for the price? So I don't understand why this world's first Bluetooth cassette player couldn't have been something like this. A stereo Walkman imitation cheapo knockoff thing. Works okay, sounds okay, playing tapes. And this already sells for around $20. I mean, take out the radio tuner, put in the Bluetooth module, probably come out around the same price. Could have sold it for $20 instead of $75, and it would play in stereo, not in mono. You can't record on it, but meh, what's the big deal? The one demo video I've seen of that Kickstarter thing recording sounds terrible, so you probably don't want to record on it anyway.
It's okay. Okay.